Not being able to have a family naturally can be very heartbreaking, but many couples also find that adoption isn't that easy either. Every year, 250,000 people are adopted, children are adopted throughout the world, but only a tiny fraction of those find families here in Australia. Here's 6.30's Maggie Palmer.
Little Posay just celebrated her fifth birthday away from her parents and siblings.
Ah!
Oh, hello!
Hello, Posay! Hello, baby!
She's Cambodian. Her adopted family, though, are in Victoria.
We met this baby and she was 18 months old and she stole my heart. That day, and we had photos and videos, and I'll never forget that.
She never did. The Patterson family ended up living in Cambodia, volunteering at the orphanage where Posay lived. They fell in love with the bubbly little girl and adopted her.
We've got the adoption certificates, we've got the passport. She is our child.
To them, perhaps, but not according to Australian law. For Aussies to adopt a child overseas, you must be living abroad as an expat. The Pattersons were for 2.5 years, but had to move home. When they applied for Posay's visa, they were told they should have lodged it overseas.
We can prove that she wasn't trafficked, we can prove that we didn't buy her, we can prove that it's perfectly legal in Cambodia.
It's been a nightmare ever since.
How can anybody with the slightest bit of common sense think that it could be this hard?
She didn't do the forms properly or whatever, as an expat, there's all this legality, which I respect, but come on, we're taking the humanity out of the equation if you don't fill out forms properly or whatever. Let's address every situation and take it for what it's worth.
Adoption advocate Deborah Lee Furness has two adopted children with husband Hugh Jackman. She sympathises with Megan.
Every child deserves to have a family and to have permanency. I mean, can you imagine a two-year-old just walking along the street? That child has no one watching its back.
13 million children worldwide don't have anyone looking out for them. Globally, 250,000 orphans are adopted every year, but only around 400 go to Australian families.
There are no exact figures on the number of Australians who are adopted or the number of couples who wish they could adopt. The census won't shed any light on the issue either. It doesn't include any questions on adoption.
We don't know the numbers. All we know is there are a lot of abandoned children. And I hear of these families that come to me saying, I would love to care and nurture a child. And it's the bureaucracy that stands in the middle.
The rules differ from state to state. Queensland, Victoria, South Australia and the Northern Territory won't let you adopt if you're gay. And in WA, the adopted child must be younger than 6 years old. Then there are the fees, up to $10,000 for a local adoption, much, much more if you're adopting from overseas. The process is confusing, not to mention time-consuming.
Can be up to a four-year wait to go on the list, that's to even before you get to first base, and then a 2 to 5 year wait until you can maybe have a placement. They are the world's most vulnerable citizens, and they're depending on the grown-ups to make the best decisions for them.
Meanwhile, the Pattersons are still waiting for a decision on their case.
It's destroying. And as she's growing, it's just getting worse. I mean, she just lost her first teeth and I wasn't there. She just started school and I wasn't there.
It's pretty hard.
Yeah. You miss her?
Yeah, very much. Very much. She's a beautiful little girl.
A bedroom is ready and waiting for Posay. So is her big sister Millie, longing for her arrival.
Very, very, very sad because it's just not really fair. It's not fair and not very nice that a sister is being kept from another sister.
How many millions of kids who need families and how many families who are desperate to be parents? It shouldn't be this hard.